It's Ashra, the autistic thrifter, and we are in my car. It's very bumpy, so sorry about that. I thought to myself, I need to record this. So you know how I put out a video last week where I did a review, or like 2 weeks ago, where I did a review of the Burberry Goddess perfume, and I was telling you how much I liked it and how obsessed I am with it and how good it smells. And then I was like, well, hopefully I don't return it. Well, I'm returning it. I'm going right now. I do like the smell, but remember when I was in my review saying that like it smells really good, but it's kind of sharp? That sharp quality is kind of like becoming more and more apparent to me the more that I wear it. And it's also, it's not lasting long on my skin at all. So it's just not really worth it for me. I'd rather continue saving up for one of the MFK fragrances, the Gentle Fluidity Gold or Baccarat Rouge. I was kind of, I think, in like a honeymoon phase with the Goddess perfume. I really liked it, and it does smell good. It does, but that sharp quality to me is just a little bit overpowering. And yeah, so I'm gonna attempt to return it. I've only had it for like a week, I think, so it shouldn't be a problem. Okay guys, I was able to return the perfume at Sephora for a full refund to my card, which is great news because that means that I can use this money towards the MFK perfume that I really want, because I also have a $25 gift card to MFK because they gave that to me when I purchased the sample set. So that means in total, I'm only gonna have to pay $78 for the new perfume, which is really good, and I'm excited, I'm really excited. I have to go inside Savers and get a green bag, so let's go. Hi guys, you are currently balanced on my microwave. I didn't end up recording anything else yesterday. I got an awesome bag at Savers that is a little bit a different shade of green than I was initially going for. I really like green lately. I think it's gonna be a big thing. Like, I think it's gonna be a trend. I don't know, I have a feeling. I was really liking like bright, not lime green, but like a bright, deep kind of green color. But I found this bag, which is not that shade, but it's still green and I really like it. And I also like mixing shades of green. So it's this bag. I think it's really cool. It's real leather and it was $15. And I think it's really cute. I love it. So I'm excited. And today we are going to the Institute of Contemporary Art, which is my favorite museum in Boston. And it's Labor Day, so it's free admission, which is really cool. And I want to show you guys my outfit real quick, but also I want to tell you that I ended up, so since I got the return from that perfume, I ended up having $140 to put toward the Maison Francis Kurkdjian perfume, and I ended up getting Baccarat Rouge 540, but I got like the small bottle of it just because I didn't want to invest in the huge bottle, not the huge, but like the middle bottle that everyone has, that little square bottle that everyone has. I didn't want to invest in that yet just because I'm not 100% certain that it's going to be something that I'm going to wear a lot. I think this little bottle might end up lasting me a while, especially because the sillage and the longevity on Baccarat Rouge is like said to be super extreme. And so you only really want to use one or two sprays. Otherwise, you're going to like choke people with it. Like, it's going to be way too overpowering. I got the smaller size bottle. It was $180 because I had a $25 credit toward that, toward the MFK website, because I bought a sample set a few weeks ago and they give you $25 every time you buy a sample set. I ended up spending $180, so I put the $140 towards it, so I only had to actually add $40, which was really cool. And then they also give you like a bunch of free stuff when you order from their site. So I think if you spend over, it's like over $125 or something like that, they give you like I got a free soap, I got a free body wash, and a free two other samples. I got Amorous Femme, the X Straight, and then I think I got another little sample of Baccarat Rouge 540, just because I was like, it'll be good because I'll have a little travel size I can keep in my bag also. Once I get it, hopefully it'll be soon. When I ordered the sample set, it came within like 2 or 3 days. So I ordered this yesterday, so hopefully it'll come really soon, and I'll do a little unboxing and everything once I get it. But let me show you my outfit real quick for the museum. So I'm wearing this little silk vest. Actually, my friend Anna Maria gave it to me because it doesn't fit her anymore, so she gave me this. And then I'm wearing this belt that I actually got from Savers yesterday. It was $5. I'm wearing this jean skirt that is from The Gap, but it was from Savers, so I thrifted it, and it was probably like $7 or $8. And then this bag, of course, that I got yesterday, and then these little loafers that are really cool. They're like a snakeskin print, and they're very comfortable. They're like a comfort brand. It's called Tripad SAS Comfort Foot were or whatever. And they were from Savers. I think they were $8. They're very comfortable.
Hi guys. This is a very exciting moment because I finally got Baccarat Rouge 540. It's known to be one of the most amazing, beautiful, unisex, but feminine-leaning fragrances of all time. It's in this box. This I want to be my signature perfume if it's what I remember it being, which I think hopefully it's going to be. I can't wait any longer. I've been waiting days for this to arrive. Well, I've been waiting months for it because I wanted it so bad, but I ordered it a few days ago, and so I've been waiting and waiting and waiting. FedEx delayed the package, and I was so upset I almost cried, but it's here. It's here, finally, so let's open it. There's all these in here, which in the past I would have had to worry about my cats eating, but unfortunately the cats are dead. Ta-da! I do not smell very good. This is what it looks like. Yay! It's very tight. I should wear this in my hair. It's funny. It's very expensive, so I kind of expect it to be pretty nice. Whoa. Okay, I am picking up on a lot of mixed scents. Hopefully nothing is spilled. Oh, yeah, I'm definitely smelling. This is the soap that they gave me. This is absolutely what I'm smelling. Wow, that's strong. It's nice. It's very nice. It smells very clean, as it should, because it's soap. So, guys, okay, let me try and give you a view. This is what it looks like upon just opening the box. Let's unbox it together. We'll save the best for last, of course, because I love torturing myself. They're generous, I guess. They give you a lot of like free stuff when you order, if you spend more than $125, I think. So they gave me this soap, which smells excellent. It is Aqua Media Cologne Forte. It's a scented soap, and it smells really good. Wow, that's a very sticky sticker. Yeah, it smells nice. It'd be like really good if your clothes smell like this. I should like put this in my drawer, actually. This is the hand and body cleansing gel sample they gave me of Baccarat Rouge 540. So I don't typically use like body washes. I use a bar of fragrance-free soap for my private parts because I'm very sensitive and I cannot get anything with scent near there. Now, I got a sample of Amorous Femme. An extrait de parfum is the most precious olfactory expression, the apex of composition, surrounding amorous from Jamaica and iris from Florence, a bouquet of sunny flowers featuring jasmine and tuberose absolutes awakens. That's what it looks like. I feel like I'm opening an Easter basket right now. Oh, it smells so good! I'm so excited. I'm so excited. I'm like gonna cry because I'm so excited. But this is the Baccarat Rouge. Ow, that hurt my eye really bad. Ow. And then now it's time for the reveal. Let's put everything back in here. I'm nervous. Everything must be cleared before I open this. This is the moment that everyone's waiting for. Baccarat Rouge 540. It's heavy. It's really heavy. In red. Imagine if I spilt it. I would be very upset with myself if I broke this. Ta-da!
It's in a little home. Okay, this is it. Baccarat Rouge 540. You can see the beautiful pink label and the gold top. And then you can see that the back of the EDP has this little chandelier that everyone loves. Let's open it. The cap's super heavy. The cap is very, very heavy. Yeah. The cap gives the bottle a lot of weight. Oh, it smells so good. It's so good, truly. It smells so good. It is wonderful, a wonderful smell. Well, one thing I will let you know is I'm probably not going to wear that Amorous Femme one tomorrow. I think I'm going to wear this one because that's really hard to not wear it. I think I should put one Sprite over here too. Okay, that was a good spray. That was a big spray. Now let's put the cap on. And now let's tuck this safely away back into its home so nothing will happen to it. I don't know what to say. It just smells really good. It's like woody to me, very woody. And at the same time, there's a sweetness to it, but it's not by any means, I would not consider this a gourmand. It's not like a typical sweet to me. I'm kind of enveloped by it right now, so it's a little bit hard for me to even like pinpoint it. Why don't I read the description to you guys? Baccarat Rouge 540, a graphic and highly condensed signature. This eau de parfum lays on the skin like an amber, floral, and woody breeze. Yeah, that's kind of exactly what I felt like. It smells like like fresh air while being like woody, and there's a sweetness, and it mixes with your skin. It's light while also definitely being there. Sometimes perfumes are light and you can barely pick up on them. Baccarat Rouge isn't like that. It's light, but you can smell it for sure. The aerial notes of jasmine and the radiance of saffron carry mineral facets of ambergris and woody tones of freshly cut cedar wood. Yeah, that's exactly what it smells like to me. It's like no other fragrance, truly. People love it, people hate it. It's extremely polarizing. But anything that is so well known is going to be extremely polarizing. The thing about Baccarat Rouge 540 is that some people pick up on a medicinal quality that smells almost like a dentist's office or something like that. I can pick up on a metallic-ish note, but to me, I would never think this smells like a dentist's office. It doesn't smell medicinal to me in that way.
But that is why it is very polarizing. There are people that will smell this and will not like it at all. And then by that same token, there's people that'll smell it and literally will hunt you down trying to figure out what you're wearing. At least that's what I've heard. And I do think that that's true, because I know that I've smelled people wearing baccarat rouge. And now that I know what the smell is, but previously I didn't know what the smell was until I got into fragrances. But this is a smell that I have smelt before, and I've always wondered what it was. I thought it was just that people, it was like just a skin thing, like it was just someone's skin smell like that, because that's what it smells like. It smells like your scent when you wear it. Like, it's like your scent mixes with this, and that's not something that all perfumes do. There are some fragrances that you spray on, you're hit immediately, it's overpowering, and it's very obviously sitting on your skin, and you only really smell it when that waves by you, or when you, you know, go up to it, or you smell it, but it's like harsh and like nauseating almost. That's how I feel about a lot of perfumes that are strong. But this one's not like that. Like, this one I can smell. It's enveloping me. It's pushing off of my skin. I can tell it's not just sitting on my skin. I can tell that it's pushing off my skin, because when I move, I'm smelling it all around me. Thanks for sticking around. Let me know what you think of baccarat rouge. I know, like I said, it's polarizing. I won't be offended if you don't like it. I think my love for it is enough for like a lot of things. That didn't make sense. What I mean is that my love for it is so strong that I don't really, it doesn't faze me if someone doesn't like it, because I know how I feel about it. So that's why I'm gonna wear it. Why else would you wear a perfume? That's it. This was a special day. A very special day. September 7th, 2023, Astra got her first bottle of Baccarat Rouge 540. And all of her money from that day on went to Baccarat Rouge 540. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe, like, comment. Let me know what you think of Baccarat Rouge. Let me know if you've smelt it, if you've worn it, if you have it. Your thoughts on dupes. You already know my stance. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye.